Videos by Yu-Gi-Oh! Smurf. Be creative. Hey guys, so today is the next episode in Cyber Talk, where we're going to be finishing up the main deck strategies, more specifically the main deck strategies involving spells and traps, but also including a nice wrap-up to the whole main deck strategy. So let's go ahead and get right off into the main affecting Cyber Dragon spell and trap cards. And the first one is Evolution Burst. It is a normal spell card, and it reads, if you control a Cyber Dragon, target one card your opponent controls. Destroy that target. Cyber Dragons cannot attack the turn you activate this card. Next up, we have Attack Reflector Unit. It is a normal trap card that reads, tribute one Cyber Dragon. Special summon one Cyber Barrier Dragon from your hand or deck. Following that is Photon Generator Unit, a quick play spell card that reads, tribute two Cyber Dragon monsters, special summon one Cyber Laser Dragon from your hand, deck, or graveyard. Moving on even further, we have Cybernetic Hidden Technology. It is a continuous trap card that reads, when an opponent's monster declares an attack, you can send to the graveyard one Cyber Dragon you control, or one fusion monster you control that lists a Cyber Dragon as a fusion material monster, then target the attacking monster and destroy that target. Getting up with the newer cards, we now have Cyber Network. It is a continuous trap card that reads, destroy this card during your third standby phase after activation. Once per turn, if a Cyber Dragon is on the field, you can banish one light machine type monster from your deck. When this card is sent from the field to the graveyard, special summon as many of your banished light machine type monsters as possible, and if you do, destroy all spell and trap cards you control. Monsters that were special summoned by this effect cannot activate their effects. You cannot conduct your battle phase the turn you activate this effect. And the last Cyber Dragon support card out there is a spell card called Cyber Repair Plant. It is just a normal spell card that reads, if Cyber Dragon is in your graveyard, you can activate one of these effects. If you have three or more Cyber Dragons in your graveyard at activation, you can activate both effects and resolve in sequence. You can only activate one Cyber Repair Plant per turn. The first effect, add one light machine type monster from your deck to your hand. The second effect, target one light machine type monster in your graveyard. Shuffle that target into your deck. So there you go. Those are the Cyber Dragon spell and trap cards that we have to offer that are specifically more geared towards Cyber Dragons. And first off, Evolution Burst, it's a fun gimmicky card that allows you to destroy monsters. Kind of like Dark Magic Attack or Blue Eyes Nova something or other. I don't know. It's pretty cool that Cyber Dragon even has one for that. And it's pretty fun to use. It can have some drawbacks, but at the same time, if you summon a Proto Cyber Dragon or a Cyber Dragon Core and then get to play Evolution Burst, it's a fun little it's a gimmick. Next up, with Attack Reflector Unit and Photon Generator Unit, we're just going to throw these in together. They summon their respective monsters, either Barrier or Laser Dragon. Barrier protects from attacks once per turn while it's in attack mode. Laser Dragon can go ahead and destroy a monster that has, I think, higher or maybe lower attack. I can't remember. I apologize. Both of these cards are pretty good. I would have to say, since both of them can be activated similar times, that Photon Generator Unit would be better because it can summon the monster, Cyber Laser Dragon, from either the hand, deck, or graveyard, while Attack Reflector Unit has that specification of hand or deck, so it kind of limits what you can do with that Cyber Barrier Dragon. But either way, both of them are pretty cool, and both of them give you some fun gimmicks to the deck. Then we have Cybernetic Hidden Technology. This card is kind of junk. It makes you lose your Cyber Dragon. It allows you to destroy the monster, but you wouldn't want to play it. Like, that gimmick isn't even fun to play with. I'd rather activate Evolution Burst and run that and only be able to play it on my turn than to have a reactionary I lose my Cyber Dragon effect. I mean, you're going to lose it anyways if they're attacking you, so why? No. I don't like it. Next up, we have Cyber Network. This card is going to be one of your key cards in the main deck strategy because the main deck strategy is all about using those gimmicks but then overwhelming with a mass swarm and mass attacks. And this is what gets you that ability, because as soon as it's sent to the graveyard, you're going to be special summoning all of your banished cyber dragons from there and just plowing them in the face. And it's really cool and really fun, and I like it. The last one we talked about was Cyber Repair Plant. This card is your search. It's a little dependent because you have to have a cyber dragon in your graveyard already, but nonetheless, it's a really cool card, and it can hit you two effects, which adds the benefit of if you have a cyber dragon in the graveyard. Granted, you have to have three or more to get both, but if you have one, you tend to have others just because of how cyber dragons kind of roll in their nature. So for on with the main deck strategy. So the main deck strategy is just going to be trying to utilize Evolution Burst with your little cyber dragons to try and clear away your opponent's advantage while steadily increasing your cyber dragon swarm. Cyber Network is going to be your kind of game ender finishers, but hands down, the card that you're definitely going to run a run to make this strategy better is Limiter Removal. It is a quick play spell card that reads, double the attack of all machine type monsters you controlled at both the activation and resolution of this card until the end of this turn. During the end phase, destroy those monsters. This card was literally limited and has been for its entire duration due to cyber dragons and gadgets. But who cares about gadgets? We're talking about cyber dragons. We'll talk about gadgets later. But due to cyber dragons, and it, why would you not already run a card that increases their attack when your whole kind of game is to deal damage and take those life points away? So you're going to want to run this, and this is going to be your real game ender, your real game finisher to that swarm that Cyber Network allows you to get. And that's really all you're going to be doing with the deck. I mean, you're going to be, like I said, you're going to be using that Cyber Barrier Dragon to try and protect and wave off some attacks. You're going to be using the Cyber Laser Dragon in conjunction with the Evolution Burst and the little Cyber Dragons to clear away your opponent's advantage. But really, when it comes down to it, you're just going to want to punch them in the face. Not literally. Use your Cyber Dragons to devour their life points. And that's how you're going to win the game with the Cyber Main Deck strategy. I would like to point out that the limiter removal remark was added to this video because of one of my wonderful subscribers, Mega Man Lan Prime. He's really cool, he's been following my videos, and thank you for this comment. I appreciate it. Keep watching, keep commenting, it really does inspire me. But thank you again for that wonderful comment. If you have any other comments of cards you think that I left out, or maybe a cool little strategy that I missed with the cards that I mentioned for the main deck, go ahead and post that in the comments below. I'll go ahead and be doing other videos about the fusion strategy and the XE strategy later, so don't worry about that. Like this video, it makes me feel warm and fuzzy inside. Share this video so your friends know what you're talking about. Subscribe to me if you deem me worthy. Have a wonderful day, guys.